Hello everyone, welcome to a new video of the Indicator Store. This is a video of the series Do It Yourself, and today we will see how to automate a bones setup with the builder of NinjaTrader 8. What we will see applies not only to an exponential moving average but for any line. On this case, it is an exponential moving average of period 34. So let's remove all of this. And let's start by defining a pattern, because on this example, I am not going to use a limit order. We are going to detect a pattern that defines bones, because using a setup at bar close looking for a pattern has some pros against using limit order tracked on intra-bar mode. Maybe on a future video we can see how to do the other method. So let's open the builder. Create a new strategy. For this example, let's create a test. And as I mentioned, it will be at bar close. By now, let's skip all the parameters. Just focus on detecting this pattern. For a long pattern, we are looking for a bar where the low is below. The low of the bar is less or equal than the entry line. And here we can place any line, the line that we want to detect the bones. In this case, it is an exponential moving average of 34. I suggest, instead of creating all the logic all together and see what happens, let's go step by step and start by drawing signals instead of placing orders, because it is easier to understand if we are going by the correct way. The easiest symbol to paint is the background, because if we place an arrow, then we need to define the vertical position. So the easiest symbol to paint is the background. We don't need to finish the strategy, we just compile, and now we can add on the chart the strategy. So we look for the test strategy. There are no parameters, because we have not added any parameter. And then we click on enable. To enable the strategy, the Ninja must be connected, because we need incoming data. And we can also enable the strategy from Control Center, from the strategy tab, from this button. And now we can see highlighted the background of the bars where this condition is true. On these two places, these places is okay, but here, for example, we are not detecting a bounce from above the line, because here it is coming from below. And also, it is not closing over the line. So we can try adding that condition, that the bar not only has a low below the line, but also it is closing over the line. So now we add that the close is greater than the same line. So EMA 34. Compile again and refresh. And now we get more closer to what we are looking for. Here the clause is over, same here, but the problem is the price is not coming. The price is not coming from above. So we can add another condition that on the previous bar there is a space. So the bar is over the line, not like here where the bar is below the line. So we can use this condition that the low of the bar, but not of the current bar, of the previous bar. So we can copy this condition with the right click, paste, and now we edit the zero reference. This is for the previous bar, one, same for the EMA. And on the previous bar, it was not less, it is greater. Click on OK, compile again, refresh, and now we get a cleaner, very precise, the bar where we are having a bounce. We have a space here, a touch, and then closing above. And following this process, we can add more and more conditions. And when we are satisfied with the current signals, then we can add the orders. So let's add an enter long, enter at market. And if we don't add target stops or a reversal condition, then take a look at what happens. If I refresh, it looks like there are no... You can see here it should be green, but this yellow means that the strategy is on the market. And the first signal on the chart entered and never exited, because there are no targets, no stops, no reversals. So it entered on the first signal and it is still here waiting. If we have, for example, a short condition, then it could be always reversing, going long, going short. But it is better to start and finish a long signal, where to enter, where to exit, and then we go to the short signals. So now, in the following step, we can define the target and the stop. The stop and the targets can be set on ticks or on currency. On this example, let's use 150 ticks for the profit and also for the stop. Compile and refresh. And now we can see that we get entries. This entry is still on the market. Here we have an entry, and here a signal without an entry. And this is because there is a parameter on the builder that we usually miss, because we need to click here, where we say how many simultaneous trades. So if the strategy is already in the market, we can specify how many consecutive or simultaneous trades we want to execute. The same that we can do is from the strategy, because this is a parameter on all the strategies. If we edit the strategy, then we can also select here how many trades we want to execute at the same time. If we place a 2, then there is a signal, an entry, another signal, and because our limit is 2, then it adds another position. What we set here on the builder are the initial conditions, but then the user can change that from the input parameters. So if we add another strategy, now we can see that the default now is 2, because we have set that on the strategy builder. So let's go. The question is, how can I have more than one position? So let's go back to only one simultaneous trade. Here, but how can I add a second position with a different target? To split a trade in two or more, then we need to add more entry orders. Instead of placing only one, I can copy that and add another more. So right click, copy, and then paste. But then we also need to have a difference between one and the other. For that, we have the signal name. So if I type a different name, like runner, for example, then on the last section, where we have the target and the stop, there is also a signal name here. If we leave this empty, this applies to all the entries without a name. But now I want to have another target, bigger, but only for the signal runner. So we compile. Now refresh. And we need to set on the settings as we saw previously, that we want to use two simultaneous positions here. And now we have two entries here, the standard and the runner. Here is ignored because the limit is 2, but we have already 2. The two positions are in place. If we got the target before, then it could enter. So we have target 1 and target 2, the target of the runner. Here we have two entries and a target. And then we get another signal. And because we had a target, the runner is still in place. So on this signal, the maximum position is 2, but we already have the runner from the previous entry. So it is entering only 1 to complete the 2 maximum positions. Some things that we can add to monitor what the strategy is doing. For example, is looking how many positions there are in place for each bar. We can add another tab and first of all check if we are in the market, check if we are long. So on the strategy tab we can select if current market position is equal to market position long, then this is going to be true when we have a position. From here to here, there are no positions at all. And what can we paint? We can try placing a text object. On a text object, we need to specify the vertical position where I want to place the text. Let's say that we want it at the height plus from here to here we have 10 points, so let's add 5. So here we place the price high with an offset of 5 points. And on the text, just for testing, just to test if it is working, let's type hello and see if it works. Compile, refresh, and something that happens here, we only get one string here on the current bar, on the last bar. The result is okay because on this bar we are in the market, we have two positions, but why it is not painting on the previous bars? This is because each object has a name, the tag name. And we can see here which is the tag name of this object. It is test text slash, underscore one. This is what we place, what we type here on the tag. It is text text underscore one. When Ninja writes again another object with the same tag, the previous is deleted because it can only be one object with the same name. To avoid deleting all objects, then we need to specify a different tag name. Something that we can add is the current bar. This is on miscellaneous, current bar. Okay. So now the name of each object will be text, text underscore one, and the number of the bar. That is always different. This applies to all the objects, arrows, dots, vertical lines, not for the backgrounds, because the backgrounds are easier to paint. They don't need a name. If we compile and refresh, now we can see that from here we get a hello over all the bars while it is in the market. Now that we found it that it is working, let's add something more useful, something that is available from Builder. Let's see what we can add instead of this text. So we can select the strategy section, and for example, we can type the current position size. Compile. So we should get 2 while both positions are working, and then 1 when only one is working, like here. 2 positions, target, 1 position, target, and so on. Here we have 1 position working, a signal, so it completes the trade size. So here we have 2 targets working and 1 stop. Something else that we can add, for example, instead of the position size. This is useful to understand what is doing the strategy, why it added or not added a new position. Here, for example, it is easier to understand why it only added 1, because we already had 1 position in place. Here we have the 2 contracts. Instead of the contract position, we can place the market position. Market position is only showing long or short, a string. We can type the unreleased PNL in currency. Compile. Maybe we want to use this as a condition. For example, when the unreleased PNL is greater than something, close everything. So now we can see on this bar we are 50 positive, then negative, minus 260 or 290. Why it is negative? Because my entry was here, and then we are below the market. Here we are in negative area. But this is unreleased. The trade is still working. When we got target one, we can see which is the profit that we got on that trade, and so on. So this is what the unreleased P&L is reporting bar by bar. So we can take a decision with that, for example. When that number is greater than something, we can close the positions. Another possible way to close a position will be the duration of the trade. So we can count the bars from the entry. For that, we need a variable that is not here. We have the released PNL, unreleased PNL. On the builder, we don't have too many options, so we will need to unlock the code. But before, when we find something that we cannot do with builder, and we need to open the code, if I unlock the code, remember that there is no way to come back. So my suggestion is create a copy of this. So we go to New Strategy Builder and select the same strategy that currently it is working. But click on Save As and select a new name. For example, test number 2. So now test is working from Builder, and now we have a copy with everything the same. The same logic, the same target and stops, everything is the same. But the difference is that now we can unlock the code. If I do something wrong, then I always come back to the original version. So click on unlock, we get this warning, there is no way to come back, and we get the editor. So let's move this out of sight. From now we work with the test number 2. And here we can see the logic, the conditions on the set number 1. Each tab has a remark showing. Here we have the profit for the runner. And something that we can do is replace what the draw is painting. Let's create a copy just in case I do something wrong. So copy and paste. And adding 2 slash bars. Then this is not going to be executed. And now I paste the copy. But I want to replace this, the unreleased inside the convert to string. We can select a parenthesis to see where is the start and the end, just to check that we have the correct number of parentheses. So now inside here, we can type what we want to show. If you press Control and Spacebar, you can find all the possible options that you can type. Most of them are easy to find how they work. One of them is the bars signs entry execution, this one. If you move the mouse over the sentence, you can see a small help, and you can see that it needs parentheses, this function. And it can also include inside the parentheses the name of the signal. On this case, we are not going to place the name of the signal. We click on compile, and here we can see the status of the compiling. We need to wait for this icon to disappear. And now I need to disable the strategy and load the new one, the test number 2. So we apply the test number 2. Only one entry. Click on OK. One entry per strategy. So on this strategy, we have one entry with two positions. So here we have an entry and the count of the bars from the last entry. So here we have another entry, same as before. So what happens if I want to have a timeout or count the number of bars and close everything? Also, what happens if I don't want to start a new entry if I am already in the market? For example, to avoid this entry. On the entry, we can add this condition, but inverted. So I can add the condition to not be long to enter long, because here we are not placing that. So if we add that condition, then we can ignore the parameter number of simultaneous trades. Now, let's continue with the timeout. What happens if at the bar number 10, that we are in the market, we want to cancel? If we are 10 bars from the entry, close everything. Here we are testing that we are long. And I am also showing the count of the bars from the entry, this number. And when this number is greater or equal to 10, I want to close. So we can add an if and parentheses. We copy this function. And inside here, we paste and say that if it is greater or equal to 10, then open and close. And in between, we type what we want to do. I want to close. So again, if we press Control and Spacebar, we can see all the functions. So we need something that starts with exits. Exit long. I can exit with a limit, but I won't. But by now, let's exit with a market order. Inside the parentheses, we can specify also the signal or the number of contracts, but let's just exit everything. Compile. And refresh. And now we can see that here we have the two entries, the standard and the runner, target number 1, and exit because we are on the bar number 10. On the following signal, then we enter with two positions instead of only one. And currently it is on the bar number 8. And what happens if we reach to the 10 without target 1? Same that happens here, for example. We have the two entries, the runner and the standard entry. There is no target, and on the bar number 10, it is closing both positions. We can see that there is a 2 on the close. Why? Because on the exit long, we didn't type the name of the signal. If I only want to close the runner, then I can type the name of the signal here. Here, when we enable a strategy, the name of the strategy, if it is not green, that means that the historical is still in the market. So we need to wait for it to complete the trade. It will happen on the bar number 10. So on the bar number 10, it will close whatever remains. And until that don't happens, then we will not have a real trade. Hope this video has been useful for you. And if you have any question or comment, please post below. Thank you. Bye bye.